Hey everyone, Cali Gold here again. Check out this map I have in front of me. This map of the entire world of Satisfactory is showing the hard drive locations. Showing the hard drive locations that I have picked up and the hard drive locations I have yet to pick up. This map is completely expandable and you can drill down into it. You can also roll over each of the locations where the hard drives are. It shows you the requirements to pick up the hard drives, shows you the altitude, the height of where the hard drive is located as well. This is an invaluable tool for me. I started using this yesterday as I needed more hard drives. As you know or may not know, alternate recipes, which are done through researching the hard drives in the MAM, is some of the most critical things that are in this game. It is going to be very difficult to function at a high level in this game without researching and using a lot of the alternate recipes, and it's the one thing in this game that truly drives the game to be a great experience. Now, how did I get to this map? How did I drive this map? Using my save file. That I'm going to show you now. So here I am on this website called satisfactory-calculator.com. This is basically the go-to place for everything you need for Satisfactory outside of the game itself, but I'm going to go to one particular area to show you about these hard drives. So I'm going to come into the website, and I'm going to click on interactive map, and it's going to bring up my map because I already did this process, but you're going to get something else here. But what you're going to do is you're going to take your save file that's located on your local drive, and you're going to drag and drop it right into here. This little green border, going to drag and drop my save file, any save file you want, right into here, and it's going to start loading it. For me, they're located in local drive, users, username, app data, local, factory game, saved, save games, and then there's one more folder, and it's this long cryptic number. Inside of that folder is where all my save files are located. So it brought it up and it just loaded everything that I have in my game. All the crap, all the stuff, down to the loot crates. But I just want to know where the hard drives are. The ones I've used, the ones are still available, and where they're located. I just come over here and these orange borders means that these things are selected. So I just come in here and I start unselecting these. So I start unselecting all of these things to remove them from the map because I don't want to see this stuff. Buildings, structures, belts. Now maybe you do want to see some of these things. It's your call on how you want to do this. I just want, for my purposes, I just want a map with the hard drives and the ones I've used and the ones I haven't used. Okay, we're getting to a point we've got an empty map here. Okay, got an empty map. Now I'm going to go down to drop pods here and I'm going to select drop pods. That's going to load in all the drop pods that I've used and the ones that are still available to pick up. The other thing is sometimes the fog of war type thing, it still hasn't resolved itself. What I do at this point, if this is the case where you've still got this, where you can't see the map because you haven't been here yet yourself, I usually just refresh the page. It shows the whole map. Is the TLDR on this? And like I said, for me yesterday after I streamed on Twitch, I just went in here and over the course of a few hours I picked up 16 hard drives rotating down through here and over here, and some of them are easier than others, no question about it. When I go for hard drives, I bring cartridges for my rifle, a lot of them. I bring plenty of stuff to heal with. Most of the hard drives are guarded in one way or another. I bring a gas mask, I bring filters, I bring a hazmat suit, I bring iodine filters. And another big thing for me is the Nobelisk, the explosives. I make plenty of those with black powder and pipes. So I come prepared. I have gear in a box that I load up on myself before I go out. I also load up a bunch of stuff, like things that you might need. Look at this one, power. This one requires 50 power. I make sure that I could lay down biomass burners and that I have fuel for it. I can make upwards of whatever, 10 biomass burners. I bring equipment for that. I go in and look through here and I make sure I've got what I need. Look at this. This requires 10 black powder. This requires electricity. It even shows if it requires electricity right here. Some might require electricity and some parts. So this is a general guide to show you. Look at this one. This is like an end game area. 7 supercomputers for this one here. So you could plan in advance if you want. I do load up plenty of stuff on me so that I have it. How do I go and do this? How do I do search for artifacts? Well, because of zooping, I just build roads in the sky and just zoop my way across the map to find these locations. That's what I do. I just zoop with foundations high above ground, and then I start going lower and lower, drop bombs, shoot things from distance, and then go and interact and pick up the drop pod. Go to the drop pod and get the hard disk. So that's how I do it. And I was able in just a few hours, like I said, to get 16 of these. I'll make more videos in the future if people want me to on this kind of stuff, but I did this yesterday and I thought it was really worthy to make a video on. So this is a very important feature in this game that you're not going to be able to function 100% in this game without alternate recipes, and the hard drive is the way to do it. And it also allows you to go out and explore. It forces you to explore. You'll find some cool stuff out there. Okay, thanks, guys. See you next time.